We define military time as a convention that divides the day in 24 hours, from midnight to midnight, or from 0 to 23, where every notation appears only once per day. This is different from the 12-hour clock, where every notation appears twice per day, adding a suffix to differentiate them, AM or PM. Although the 12-hour clock is one of the most common time conventions in the world, military time has been the standard for some industries and professions. But how and why? Well, let's look at the origin first. The 24-hour system, aka military time, was originated by the Egyptian system of decans, in which time was measured with a position of 36 different constellations. In East Asia, they used military times before the westernization of their culture. Some 12-hour Western-made clocks were changed to the Asian system before shipping. It is believed that the Prague Orjol was one of these clocks. Mechanical public clocks were introduced in Italy. They used military time and began the hour counting 1/2 hour after sundown. However, chiming clocks had to use a lot of rope to produce the 300 strokes required for that. So some localities ended up switching to 12-hour clocks that only need 156 strokes, 2 laps per day. In the late 19th century, Sir Sandford Fleming, a Scottish inventor, proposed the use of one 24-hour clock for the entire world, linked to the Greenwich Meridian. He promoted the use of worldwide standard time zones and influenced the creation of the Coordinated Universal Time, commonly known as UTC. Then, the International Meridian Conference adopted the idea to set the universal day as the mean solar day, as we can notice in this resolution quote during the conference. That this universal day is to be a mean solar day, is to begin for all the world at the moment of midnight of the initial meridian coinciding with the beginning of the civil day and the date of that meridian, and is to be counted from 0 up to 24 hours. In the coming years, the Canadian Pacific Railway, where Fleming was an engineer, was among the first organizations to adopt the 24-hour clock. Then, the system was adopted by other Western countries. Also, the Indian Railway switched systems to military time as well. Some armed forces switched to military time during World War I, including the US Navy, who was the first US organization to join. But the US Army adopted it officially until World War II. In the UK, the system has failed to establish successfully after several attempts. The British Royal Navy was the first military force to switch. Nowadays, the British Rail Company and the London Transport use the 24-hour clock for their timetables, and the BBC uses a mixture of both systems, same as other English-speaking countries. The 24-hour clock is ruled by ISO 8601, established in 1988. And as most of us know, the system works in this format. Midnight is noted this way, representing the beginning of the next day, but if you want to mean precisely that the given day is finished, it is okay to use this format to represent midnight. In some countries like Japan, it's actually common to find notations of military time representing the hours beyond the 24 or the 23. For example, if a bar or club is open till 6 a.m., they would advertise that as being open until 30 a.m. or 3:00, in part because closing time is part of the same business day, and also with the goal of avoiding any ambiguity. Times after 24 hours are also used in some contexts where business hours extend beyond midnight, like in broadcast television schedules. This kind of form is rarely used for daily talks. Computers and operating systems like Microsoft Windows and macOS represent time with a 24-hour clock as well. You can, of course, switch it to a 12-hour system if you prefer. In medicine, military time is used when it's time to set a patient's clinic register and to avoid any misunderstanding about any medical event or medication time. Emergency services and rescue bodies use it often as well. Most industries like navigation, tourism, astronomy, and meteorology use military time to avoid any inconvenient situations. The 24-hour clock got recognition as military time due to how much it is used by armies around the world. There are some very specific rules for them. First, they don't use a separator for hours or minutes, and append a letter of the time zone at the end. For example, if you're in Sao Paulo and want to write the hour at 8:49 p.m., you would write this, and then the P indicates the time zone where Sao Paulo is. The letter is spoken using the native phonetical alphabet, so for this hour you would say 20:49 Papa. For the universal time standard, the designated letter is Z, spoken as Zulu time. For any local time, the designated letter is J, spoken as Juliet. Hours or clock are always given as hundreds instead of thousands, so 11 a.m. would be spoken as 1100 hours, instead of 1100. 6 a.m. would be spoken as 0600 hours, and so on. By the way, do you know what time it is now? It's subscription time, 100 Juliet. Check out our poll and let us know what time zone they use in your country. And then subscribe to our channel if you like this video, leave us a comment, and all that other stuff. We'll see you next week. Stay fresh.